Hi guys, it's your girl Yemi.com, and thank you for joining me, my internet friends. I am doing a video that I think is going to be super interesting, something that some of us don't talk about because they're what? Guilty pleasures. Recently, I started watching this podcast with Garrick, Kelsey, and Zach from the Try Guys, and their podcast is called Guilty Pleasures, and they talk about their movie Guilty Pleasures. Now, I love this podcast.
Wait, hold on. Jared just walked in. What did you just look? Show the camera what you just walked in with.
Aww.
What the fuck?
Oh my god!
Did you hear me talking?
A gentleman caller arrives, Kelsey.
I call myself Lady Dara.
Oh my god!
My boyfriend just walked in with like 20 fucking roses. That doesn't happen.
I feel like it happens a lot.
That was
and you're
wild.
Trying to downplay it.
I love the way they break it down, but I have some movie or TV guilty pleasures that I love to watch on a sad rainy day or if I'm feeling down or whatever. Like, and I feel like guilty pleasures and like actual TV that you just like to watch are kind of different. Like, guilty pleasures are more for like comfort. You can rewatch them, like things that like really just keep you in a good spirit. Things you like to watch are medium that you just like to consume, that you like, whether it be visuals or whatever. So that's kind of the difference, I think. I think there's a little bit of shame, but not necessarily shame to it. It's more like, oh, this is something that I don't think a lot of people like, necessarily like or agree, but it gives me the warm fuzzies. So, with that being said, we're going to talk about my personal guilty pleasures. I highly recommend, obviously, all of these things. And not forcing you to watch it, but if you want to watch it, go for it. But first, we need my handy dandy notebook. Okay, so I wrote down all my favorite guilty pleasure movies. Some of them will surprise you. There's a couple TV shows on here. Let's get started. First thing is a musical. I know there are a lot of people in the world who hate musicals. There's no secret to be held. I am a Broadway kid. I love Broadway. I love to watch it. I have a Broadway shower playlist that I listen to all the time. Midnight Radio from Hedwig and the Angry Inch is my wake-up ringtone. So it's no surprise that I like musicals, but I know a lot of people don't like musicals. So musicals are kind of a very big guilty pleasure for me, but more so than musicals, these two specific musicals are my hugest guilty pleasures that I really love to watch when I'm feeling down. The first one is The Greatest Showman. I don't think this is necessarily, I think this is the least guilty pleasure I have on this list. I think everyone I've talked to really likes the movie, but there are some people that I know that hate the movie, and I don't know why, because I think it's amazing. I went to go see it like 3 times in theaters, like, just because it was just so good. I was like watching and waiting for the trailer to drop. Like, I was like, oh my god, Zendaya in this purple hair. Oh my god, it's everything. Ah, I need to watch it. Oh my god, Zac Efron, Zendaya, my Disney fantasies are coming true. So, I was super excited for it to drop. I love Hugh Jackman, obviously. I love his musical career. So, you know, I was like, you know what? I'm super excited for this. And literally, I love this musical. I love this musical so much. You want to know how much? I have a vinyl of The Greatest Greatest Showman, and I listen to it frequently. I love it. My only complaint about it is that it's not in the order that it appears in the movie. So, like, it... Or is it? Oh my god, I think it is. Wow, it actually is. I'm bugging. Whoops. It is. Okay. But I really love it. I really love the show. I really love the movie. I love listening to Zendaya sing. I love when Zac Efron sings. I love when Hugh Jackman sings. I love Keala Settles. I love Keala Settles. I saw her on Broadway in the show Waitress, and she was amazing. When I heard that she was a part of this project, I obviously was super, super excited. I know Jeremy Jordan helped out that one time when, like, Hugh Jackman hurt his tonsils in New York. But I super love everyone in the show. And the storyline. I don't love P.T. Barnum because we all know he was a racist, but I mean, anything for a good show. I do like the idea of a showman and a Cirque du Soleil center situation. The second musical is actually a Disney Channel original movie. It's called Lemonade Mouth. I know. Okay, listen, that movie was a very integral part of my childhood. And by childhood, I mean when I was just like aging out of Disney, that movie came out. And I loved it because I love Bridget Mendler. Sleep with the fishes down in Everness. Oh my lord, where's my soul? Asleep with the fishes down in Atlantis. I know sometimes you lose sight of hope. Know that you don't falter often. When you do, you grow. Know that life could have you lost like your compass broke. Slip the drip of sea on me just trying to be your rope. I still love her to this day. I love her acting skills, her singing skills. Her musical singing skills are beautiful. I love when she sings. However, I hated Good Luck Charlie, so I was like, man, I was literally pushing myself to watch Good Luck Charlie just so I could get that Bridget Mendler, like, watch, you know? Support your sister, let her get her coin. But, eventually, like, she came out and was in Lemonade Mouth, and I was like, oh my god, yes, she's gonna sing, and she's in this, that's, like, beautiful. And then, of course, Hayley Kiyoko is in it. I knew her from something else. I can't remember what the first thing I ever saw with her in it was, but she's, again, a reoccurring theme of my childhood. But when I found out them two were in it, I was like, gotta watch it, gotta love it. And I still love that musical to this day. Granted, I am upset that they did not do it justice by adding my favorite song, Living on a High Wire, into the actual musical, because that is my favorite one. Living on a high wire, running through the Wi-Fi. You can't shake me, I'm not going nowhere. Walking on a tightrope, no net high hopes. Step back, I'm gonna make it over. Na 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 but I still super love it. I love the story. It's very cheesy, very kiddie. It still surprised me in some aspects, like the fact that Charlie didn't get with Mo, was a little upset about that. I thought they were going to get together. They did not. Whatever. We'll move past it. But it was really, really great in that aspect. And it did hit some, like, bigger themes. Like, her dad was in prison for killing her mom. I don't know. Maybe. Probably. Prove me wrong, Disney. Prove me wrong. And, like, the music was always super amazing. All of the songs were really, really good. I think, like, so many YouTuber commentaries have also, like, just, especially right now, like, this resurgence of watching old DCOMs, like, so many people have talked about it, and they all agree that the music was so good. The music was so good from that movie, to the point where I can still rap Wen's rap verse from Determinate. You think I'm kidding? It's when and have a set music like better, renegade, lemonade, use it, renegade, say, go ahead, try to bay way better to reason our homework, speaking of spinners, even Peter made a brother because we feel that it's really stab. Now hurry up and let us in now, because we come to your house and people are smiling like lemons and out on the real deal. You know what I feel? When I in front of me, I'll just in front of throwing down. Now we'll play around, put up on the ground and make that sound. Yes, that was the one take. I'm not proud of it, but I do know it. So that is another one of my guilty pleasures from the musical aspects. There is one more musical that I guess is technically a musical that is guilty. This is only a guilty pleasure for me because A, it's a very bad musical. B, I talk trash about it all the time to anyone who will listen, even though it's kind of blasphemous. And C, Beyonce is a part of it. It's Carmen, a hip opera. I recently rewatched it and it became a recent guilty pleasure because I remember watching it when I was really young and I was like, this is garbage. As I grew up, I just kept that same mentality. Like, I would, like, anyone would, I'm like, Carmen the Hip Hopper was not it. Why are we all playing? Beyonce cannot act, even though, you know, she is our queen, you know, she is American royalty. Don't forget it, don't forget it. Respect that. Bow down, bitches. I took some time to live my life, but don't think I'm just his little wife. Genius Negro?
Okay, Beyonce hardworking, yes. Bad as hell, 100%. Genius? Hard no. She's more of like a an entertainer than a genius.
I want to set you on fire right now.
Thank you, Anna, because this is crazy. Aaron, you're crazy.
I am triggered right now that this dumbass has the cojones to say that Beyonce's not a genius.
And you have every right to be triggered. You know why? Because how is it that a hardworking, exhausted, talented young woman is putting in all of these work hours and isn't a genius?
This was not it. But then I rewatched it because someone told me, like, recently, like, literally last year, like, within the last year, it was like, you should watch it before you judge. I rewatched it and I was like, wow, I go back to it all the time. Like, the songs weren't, like, amazing, but Carmen's entrance song was everything.
Weakness flowing like a faucet, body banging, no corset. Brothers want to toss it, but they lost because my gang made them forfeit. Slicker than a porpoise and thicker than the horses. Carmen Brown got the whole town speechless. I stick to my thesis, I stick to my features.
If I had to choose an entrance song, that's the song I would choose because it is so good. Like,
I'm thicker than a porpoise, I'm thicker than a horses. Carmen Brown got the whole town speechless. I stick to my thesis, I stick to my features.
It's so good. Mekhi Phifer's in it. I do love Mekhi Phifer. I don't know why, but I do. Mo Steph is in it. There's like a lot of heavy hitters in it. Wyclef Jean is in it.
Girlfriend!
he's like,
get me over!
Like, he really sells that witch doctor vibe. He was the original Dr. Facilier. But, so that's like a really guilty pleasure. It's only I made it a guilty pleasure because I'm guilty of slandering this movie so much, but I actually watch it all the time, especially when I just need like something to take my mind off of everything. So those are my three like musical aspects that I would say are my guilty pleasures. Let's see what else is here. I have one movie and then one kind of like different-y kind of thing. So the movie is the Crazy Rich Asians. Now, I know a lot of people like Crazy Rich Asians and a lot of people don't like Crazy Rich Asians. Like it's a mixed bag. I call it a guilty pleasure because I watch it no reference to the plot. I can just watch scenes of this movie and it will just brighten my day. Specifically, the wedding scene, because it is the most stunning scene ever.
So take my hand, take my whole life too.
And I'm like emotionally attached to it because Keanu Grinnies is the one who's singing Can't Stop Falling in Love at the wedding, and I love her so much. I remember, like, I used to follow her YouTube channel religiously, like back in the day where like the YouTube was wild, wild west. Like, I would, like, I remember she won a contest for, like, the Super Bowl, and I, like, voted religiously for her for that contest. Like, that's how far back it goes with this girl. Like, I watched her series with Harry Shum Jr. Like, I stand her to a T. So that wedding scene always gets me, just because it's so beautiful and magnificent and ethereal, and then her voice is just so much, and I get welled up with tears and it makes me wink and I love it. And then any scene with Astrid in it is just another banger.
Not only did she graduate top of her class at Oxford, start multiple charities, and is a fashion icon, Astrid has the biggest heart of any of my cousins.
Mommy. Stop talking.
What?
Don't worry about packing your things. You bought this apartment. You keep it. We're leaving.
What do you mean you're leaving? Where are you gonna go?
I have 14 apartment buildings that I own, so probably one of those.
Damn!
But I've just realized it's not my job to make you feel like a man. I can't make you something you're not.
Especially that last scene where she says her iconic line of, "It's not my job to make you feel like a man." I'm like, oh, girl, yes, it's not your job. But any scene she's in is just immediately amazing from her. I love Gemma Chan so much. Like, she's just so great. Like, obviously everyone in that movie was super talented in acting, but Gemma Chan, she's on another level, okay? But speaking of actresses, this next guilty pleasure, it's really two movies, but it's mostly, it's not even because of the movies, it's because of the person. There's an actress who sparked joy in my life, and it also comes from my musical theater background, because I first saw her in the 10th anniversary for Les Mis with Nick Jonas playing Marius, and she was playing, she's the forever Eponine. And I'm talking about Samantha Barks. Samantha Barks is forever Eponine. She's played Eponine in so many shows. She played Eponine in the Les Mis movie. She crushed it, was the best singer and actor for that. I loved her in it. But I just like watching her act and sing, and she's just so talented. And she's not casted in enough things. So really, it's like, I try and watch her wherever I can, and that's kind of my guilty pleasure, but specifically, it's me watching her scenes in Les Mis, and then me watching the movie For the Love of Money. It's a typical rom-com, British-y rom-com kind of thing, where she's playing like this woman trying to scam a man out of his money. It's like really funny, they're back and forth, they're tit for tat, but there's this scene that gets me every time. It's where she's like, she's gone home and you see like the actual person she is, which is just a broken person, like who's just had to deal with all of this nonsense. And he has been ruining her like life, like just torturing her, and he knows her favorite song, and she's just crying in bed, and he just lays down next to her and he plays her favorite song, which is a banger of a song. It's a Tom Walker song. It's so good. It's so good. Tom Walker's voice is very grunty and beautiful, and it's just a really beautiful thing that I connect with every time. I don't know why, but I get weak.
Thank you.
summer will be undone. Lying like John in your coat. Fake out that sanity. Am I tripping? Are you with me? Cause darling, you're the only one. The world is going mad. You and I can hide away. I can't stand the TV screen. Turn it off, pull the plug. They can try, they won't find us. Slow down your heartbeat.
So that's really my guilty pleasure in that. It's really just Samantha Barks.
They can't raise my pride. I've seen a better life. I've seen the other side. I can't go back.
I can't go back.
I can't go back. I can't go back.
I can't go back.
I'm a different girl. I can't go back.
So, TV shows. Now, for TV shows, I like good TV. I like interesting shots, like not highbrow, really great cinematography, dialogue-based TV. But I also like hot garbage. Like, and not like hot garbage, I also like just like good family time cinema. And these two fall under it. The first one is both of them are on Netflix. The first one is Family Reunion. I know that theme song front back, side to side. My sister hates it when I sing it. Like, I want you to be my family. They're coming down south to stay with me. Big Mo, do you love me? Yeah, I'm Coco. Dating in the house, I got on my face. I'm your big sis, can't miss Redneck. Call me shopping down. I'm the street rocking down. Oh my god, it's so good. It's such a good theme song, but they have like three seasons out. I've watched all of them multiple times. It's just so feel good. Like, I grew up on Tia and Tamara, so seeing her act again makes me so happy. I love seeing her on screen. I love seeing this like beautiful black family. I love how they made me love Jade.
Again, I am so sorry. Hey, Madeir met Martin Luther King Jr. Shut up.
Oh, well, I see the apple don't fall far from the disrespectful tree.
Like, the progression, her progression of as a character matches her hair arc, and that just makes me so happy. I think that is so underrated. Like, and then, like, the fact that Coco always has, like, these different hairstyles. It's like a true Southern black family moment, and I love it. I love it. It's so funny. It's so cute. It's so wholesome. It's so happy. And then
I love your natural curls. You look perfect.
But I just look like me.
Exactly.
But I want to be beautiful. I want to win that crown so everyone will know I'm special.
You do not need makeup, Jade. Whether you win or not, you are a beautiful black woman.
Get on the ground now!
Get down, yo, get down! What's going on?
I said down now!
Do what he says, Mozzie.
Okay. Please don't shoot us.
Yeah. Oh my god!
Mommy!
Shaka!
Back up, ma'am. Let us do our job.
What the hell's going on here?
We got a call. Some suspicious men were roaming the neighborhood trying to break into houses.
What? Men? These are little boys.
We live here.
There's like classic black mamas of TV. And one of our queen du jour, our classic black mamas, is on this screen. Like, we all know Jennifer Lewis is our badass black mama, okay? But Miss Loretta is our down-home, southern, church hymn-singing, pie-baking grandma of black television, and we love her for it. So I love seeing her on screen. She just, it's just a very cute and lovely family wholesome dynamic. On the flips twist side, there's another show that came out simply recently, like within the last year, and it has quickly become my favorite. I've watched it like 5 times. There's only 10 episodes, so 60 episodes, that's a lot. I've watched it like 5 times. It's called Country Comfort. Okay, when I explain the show Country Comfort to you, it is basically the nanny but Southern. That's what it is. It's the nanny but Southern. Like,
now I'm really scared.
Fran Drescher, but make her a cowgirl. Like, you know, it's basically Catherine McPhee plays the main character. She is a nanny. Well, she's a singer who eventually becomes a nanny to this big family that recently lost their mom. And really, she needs them more than they need her. They go on wacky adventures. It's beautiful, wholesome, great content. I started watching it because Catherine McPhee's in it. And I love Catherine McPhee. Like, okay, my love of Catherine McPhee is deep. It runs very deep. I used to work at Billboard, and I ran into her one time. She was doing a podcast that I was filming for, and a live show that I, like, got to watch. She, like, gave me, she, like, was so sweet to me, so nice. Like, she gave me a signed copy of her CD, which I still have and listen to. Her voice is magic. And she's just such a talented singer and an equally talented actress.
I'll show them all how goddamn happy I am. Sugar, butter, and flour, don't let me down. You can shower me with riches every year the night we met. I may take it from your mountain like it's all. It's going coyote ugly up in here, no Tyra. Yeah, it's only up from here, no downward spiral. Change the clothes and fix the nose.
And then 5, 6, 7, 8,
action.
Action.
Now I'm blonde, but I ain't so dumb. Hollywood will be under my thumb. I'll change partners until I become. Because the medals on my chest will make them weak in the knees. And I promise I will rest till we're all at ease. Yeah, I never met a woman who didn't love to howl. No, I never met a man who wasn't on the prowl. Because a boy with a gun thinks it's fun to shoot. And that's a real big 21.
You wouldn't lie, should I tell? I tell you I'm willing to learn. So enroll me in school, in your kidney-shaped pool. In a two-piece, I make quite a splash. Cause I wanna be a smash.
Paula streaks because Ralph does it. He loves to paint. And don't tell me that he needs help either. He's challenged. Have some empathy.
Challenged, huh? Look at Sylvester and him. Do you know what they're doing? He's playing chess with a grandmaster who's about to lose.
Walter, you see this? Checkmate in 8 moves. This kid is amazing.
I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news. Your son is genius.
Let me be your star.
Like, I remember watching her as Scorpion at the time, and I was blown away by her acting skills. So, of course, I watch everything she's in. So, I was like, all right, I'm gonna watch it. Let's see how this fares. And I ended up really loving it and really loving the family aspects. Obviously, there's music in it, so that got me hooked.
Of my life, would you be my?
my partner every night. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. You touch me like this, and when you hold me like that, it was gone with the wind, but it's all coming back to me.
And a lot of people don't know this about me because I only talk about K-pop and then like sometimes R&B and rap, but I really do love country music. I love country music. One of my favorite moments on television is watching Catherine McPhee actually do a cover of Redneck Woman on Smash. Insert clip here. Literally one of my favorite things on television ever, like my favorite moments. So seeing her just embrace that Southern hospitality in her, and it's like an extended season of that.
No skins.
Locked and loaded. I've been fooling my friend's mom since they're thinking I'm a good influence for years.
She's in.
What?
Just a real mess.
Oh, hey, listen. Aren't you from the nanny agency?
No.
Dang. Do you have any experience taking care of kids?
No.
Do you have any experience flying? I do.
Hey, yo, put me our new nanny.
Would find true love along the broken road.
Plus her singing, guest stars. It's so fun, and I love it. And then the last.
Every long, lost dream led me to where you are. Others who broke my heart, they were like no.
God bless the broken road that led me straight to you. Oh, straight to you.
Musicals, so like movies. We've hit actors, we've hit television, but we haven't hit web series yet. Okay, so hear me out. Hear me out. We're gonna hit this last one and close the book, y'all. Side Effects. So there's a web series called Side Effects. I am a big fan of mixed multimedia. And Side Effects is a show about a girl who mother passed, father went missing. And so she takes pills for antidepressants.
No wonder we had to medicate you. You let him leave us?
She lives with her whole family. Her brother had to drop out of med school to come take care of all the siblings. It's this kind of like mystery journey that is all we did through popular music, but also like these music moments are like kind of symptoms of her having to take these antidepressant medicines. So it's really interesting. I got into it because one of the stars of it is Lulu Antariska, and she used to be on How to Rock on Nickelodeon, and she was amazing. She has a very beautiful voice, but she was that, it was like Victorious moment where it's like you didn't let her sing enough. Like, and that's no shade to Symphonique because she was hitting the notes. But Lulu really didn't get to sing on this show, but she sings in this and she sounds great. And I love her as an actress. Again, another super underrated actress. So I always follow her career, and then I saw she was in this and then I fell in love with it. I reach watch it at least once a year. If I just am like, I want to listen to popular music, but I also want a story, I go to it. It's really great. It's really beautiful. Like this whole, and the way that the scenes work out, there's like a lot of like mixed mediums in it. The way that they edit it is really interesting to me and amazing. And I really like, just really love it. It's like someone was like told a first year editing student, gave them a full graphics package and was like, go off, sis. And I love it. With that being said, we have closed the book. I'm yummy.com. Those were my guilty pleasures, my internet friends. Don't worry, I will be back, so stay tuned.